have to talk about Ahmed Mohamed, the 14-year-old Texas teenager who was arrested last week for being an intelligent Muslim. For those who don't know, Mohamed built a clock and brought it to school to show his teacher, where he was promptly arrested because everyone thought it was a bomb. And the only reason that everyone thought it was a bomb is because Mohamed is a Muslim. There's no question that this student was racially profiled, and that's the first and most important problem. But the second problem is that the student is still being attacked by both the left and the right. Sarah Palin came out on Twitter and appeared to go after the student's intelligence, saying that her kid's pencil boxes weren't as cool as Mohamed's. Not quite sure what that means, but it's Palin, so whatever. The attacks from the left, coming from people like Bill Maher and Richard Dawkins, are similar. While both agree that the student is owed an apology, Maher believes that there's no problem with racially profiling the student because Muslims build bombs and blow things up. That's what he said. Dawkins agrees that all religion is evil, but he also took a shot at the kid's intelligence, saying that he didn't do anything other than put pieces of a clock back together. Why is being smart a bad thing in America today? Even if all he did was reassemble a clock, can Richard Dawkins do that? Or Maher or Palin? In last week's GOP debate, Louisiana Governor Bobby Jindal said that the only people in the United States who are discriminated against are Christians. But this latest incident and the entire practice of racially profiling Muslims, African Americans, and Hispanics far outnumbers the incidences of Christian discrimination, which for all practical purposes doesn't even exist, but that's what Republicans believe. Ahmed Mohamed is an extremely intelligent young man, and he was unfairly singled out because of his religion. Now, can't we move beyond this in America, or are we so blinded by our hatred and fear that we can't tell the difference between a terrorist and an honor student?